Okay, good afternoon, students. Today we will going to discuss the next topic. That is a theoretical topic, computer networking. Okay, so in your syllabus there is a computer networking, type of network, PAN, LAN, MAN, WAN, wired and wireless communication, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, cloud computing, private and public. Then there is another topic, multimedia, image, audio, video, and animation. So the only the theoretical portion is left. So today we will start computer networking. So when we do the work in any PC, that PC is scattered, is not connected with any other device. Okay. So when whatever you are doing is in a single PC, and that PC is called standalone computer. Standalone computer is a computer that is not connected with any other computer. So there are number of limitations of standalone computers. So standalone computer. A computer that is not connected with the other computers. So there are number of limitations. So limitations are no data sharing. No data sharing means if one file is created in first computer, if the computer is not connected with other computer, so if we want to use it in second computer, this is not possible. So data sharing is not possible. This is possible that in a first computer you insert the pen drive and copy the data and go to the second computer and paste the file there. But without this, this is not possible that the file of one computer can are accessible in another computer. So there is no data sharing. Secondly, no software sharing. So in a suppose MS Word is installed in a second computer, and you are doing the work in first computer, and you want to use the MS Word, so this is not possible. Software sharing is not possible in the case of a standalone computer. Number three, no communication. So you can't send text messages from one computer to another computer. Okay, first computer to second computer. So these are some drawbacks of data of a standalone computers. So we can't share data, we can't share software, there is no any communication. So these type of limitations are removed by networking. So solution is networking. So what is networking? What is a networking? Networking is an interconnection between different computers. So it is an interconnection. It means all the computers are interconnected with the help of wire or wireless. So we create a network. But in a real life, when you connect your mobile phone with your computer system, this is a network. So networking is an interconnection between different computers. So now, computer that are connected with any network is called node. Any computer that is connected with network is called node. A computer connected with any network is called node or workstation. It is also called workstation. Node or workstation, the same thing is there. Clear? So these are called workstation, node or host computer or host. So there are three terms using the same same concept, that is a computer that is connected with the any type of network is called node or workstation or a host computer. Now, according to the distance, because in the networking we are connecting different devices, so according to the depending on the distance, your networks are of different types. So we are now going to discuss different types of network. So here is first one is LAN. LAN stands for local area network. So in this type of network, your devices are very close to each other. Clear? This is called local area network. For example, take the example of computer lab, take the example of any bank branch, okay? Take the example of any local office, okay? All the computers are interact with each other and they are very near to each other. So this type of network is called local area network. And basically, the LAN is up to 20 kilometers. Clear? So if it is above 20 kilometers, we say that it is not a LAN. So it means the distance between two computers can be up to 20 kilometers. So this is local area network. Now, second, this is called MAN. MAN stands for Metropolitan Area Network. So in a metropolitan area network, this is a bigger than LAN. In this type of network, the computers are not very near to each other. So take the example of city cable, okay? The different houses are connected, but these houses are not very near to each other. Okay, so you have to ask, which network can I create? Karega? This is called MAN, Metropolitan Area Network. Third one, that is called WAN, Wide Area Network. So in a wide area network, it crosses the city's boundary. Clear? So when we connect a computer for one city with another computer in another city, this type of network is called wide area network. Clear? So internet or your telecommunication system, these type of networks are of a WAN type, wide area network. Clear? So according to the distance, there are three broad categories of networks. One is LAN, MAN, and WAN. LAN stands for local area network. Computers are very near to each other. MAN is for metropolitan area, when one building is connected with another building. And last one is when this is when the network is cross the city boundaries. This is called wide area network. So examples of LANs, LAN is computer lab in any school or college. Okay. Then you can take the example of any bank branch or local office. These are the examples of which one? Local area network. And in the case of metropolitan area network, example is local cable. When we discuss the digital TV, that is example of wide area network, not a MAN, okay? But local cable is example of a metropolitan area. And when internet, okay, then your telecommunication, okay, your telecommunication or telephone, you can say these are the examples of a wide area network. Okay, students, any doubt in this? Yes, Arush, any doubt in this? Okay, better. Now, next is there is another term given in your book, your syllabus is PAN. PAN stands for personal area network. Yeah, you can say it is a private network. When we create very, very small network between different devices, this is called PAN. Clear? In a PAN, for example, you connect your mobile phone with your computer system. This type of network you have created is called PAN. Clear? Very small network. Network by using which you are connecting different devices. So this is called PAN. Personal area network. Our next term is wired and wireless communication. So in the case of your networking, they may be wired or wireless. Wired means you are using wires, you are using cables. There's a physical connection between two or more computers. So these are called wired. So in a wired media, this is also called guided. Okay. These are communication medias. So they may be wired or guided. Clear? So in this we include different cables. So these cables may be twisted pair cable. Then there is a coaxial cable. Number three, there is fiber optic or optic fiber. Same thing is there. So these are the three different type of wires we are using: twisted pair, coaxial cable, fiber optic. In the case of twisted pair, this is a very old technology. When you are using your landline phones, there is a very delicate wire is there. In this wire, two cables are twisted, are with each other. This type of cable is called twisted pair. In your broadband, there is RJ45 cable, gray color cable. That is again a twisted pair cable. If you see the connector of RJ45 cable, there is a different pairs of different wires, okay? So of different colors. So this is called a twisted pair cable. But coaxial cable, there is little bit different. In the case of coaxial cable, take the example of your digital TV cable. There is a very hard or strong cable in which there are different layers, and the twisted pair is a very delicate cable. It means due to the atmosphere effects, there is some breakage is there, some noise is there, but in the case of coaxial cable, it is very strong because there are different layers, different covers are there. So coaxial cables are strong. There is no any external noise is there due to the atmosphere. But last one is fiber optic. In this, we use the glass, and the wire is a very delicate wire, but the data is traveled in the shape of light. Okay, so these are present time is a optical fiber time. We have fiber optical time in which now internet is not a your copper based. Your twisted pair is a copper based wire. Your wire. So now the wire, the fast for fast internet processing, there is an optical fiber cables. Clear? So these are different type of cables we are using for networking. GI, it is clear, beta?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So next one is wireless. Wireless, or it is called unguided. Unguided. So in this type of network connection, we are not using any physical connection. There is no any wire. There are wireless signals. Okay, so this type of networks media is very famous. So here in this we are using microwave radio wave satellite then Bluetooth there is also Wi-Fi is here so these are wireless or unguided. So in this satellite having a large area, global you can say. So in this type of network, one country is connected with another country. But when we are using microwave or radio wave, these are connected between the small area. For example, in the case of Doordarshan, there are in Jalandhar there is a very big antenna is there that is connected with the Doordarshan Delhi. So this is this type of network is called wireless network is called microwave or radio wave, and there is also Bluetooth signals are there, but Bluetooth signals are used for a very short distance. These are not for long. A satellite is for very long distance, but mitosis for very short distance. And then another type of Bluetooth basically used in telecommunication industry. Okay, so in your mobile phones, there is a PDAs are there, the Bluetooth facility is there. With the help of these signals, we can send the data from one device to another device. Next is Wi-Fi. Yes, who will tell the full form of Wi-Fi? Dianshika, what is the full form of Wi-Fi?
Sir, wireless fidelity.
Wireless fidelity. So this is a wireless signals, and its range is from 2.4 gigahertz. Within the, not X, above, okay? Or you can say, okay, 2.4 gigahertz. So very small distance is there, not a very large distance. So with the help of this, we can transfer the data. These are used in the latest digital device like laptop, is mobile phones. So internet is, we can use with the help of Wi-Fi signals. But for Wi-Fi, there are some more categories. There are Wi-Fi hotspot, I'm checking whether these terms are in your syllabus or not. No, these are not in your terms. Wireless and wired and wireless communication is here. And the meaning of a Wi-Fi. The next is cloud computing. Students, at present time, if you want to use any software, any app, so there is no any requirement that you install that softwares in your computer system or your mobile phone. So there are some cloud computing is there. Cloud computing means cloud is here means server. It means this the softwares are installed in server, and as a customer, as a user, we are using that. So this type of the server-based computing is called cloud computing. So programs are installed in internet. So these are not installed in your hard disk. So I'm taking one example of your Gmail. So I'm going to open Gmail. So in your email ID, there is one feature that is called Drive. If you open the Drive and click on New, you can create any document just like MS Word. You can create Google Sheets just like your Excel sheet or your Calci sheet. You can create Google Slides just like a PowerPoint slideshow or Impress. So you can create Google Forms. So these are different softwares installed in Google server. So if you have no any, suppose you have not installed MS PowerPoint, so don't worry about that. Log in your Gmail, go to the Drive and click on New and click on Google Slides. By using that, you can create slideshow. Even then, you are not installed PowerPoint in your computer system. So this is called Google, that is called cloud computing. Inside this Gmail Drive, I can also copy and paste different files. So here, suppose I copy this file and drag it and copy there. So file will be copied in server. So this is called cloud storage. So there is a difference between cloud storage and cloud computing. Cloud storage means saving your data in server, but cloud computing means using different applications installed in server. Titiksha, it is clear with her?
Yes, sir, everything is clear.
Okay. Priyanshika?
Yes, sir.
Gia, any doubt in this?
No, sir.
So, the meaning of cloud storage is cloud storage or cloud computing. It refers to storing and assessing data and programs over the internet instead of your computer hard disk. So in your, you are not using your computer hard disk. You are just using the hard disk of your server. Okay, you are assessing the data and program over the internet, means the data and program saved in server you are using. So this is called cloud computing. Next is there are different types of cloud computing. So number one is public cloud. So here cloud means server. Then private cloud. So these are the two terms, public cloud and private cloud. So we are going to discuss these two terms. So private clouds or public clouds. So difference is very clear. Public clouds are available for general public. it means these are not restricted to any particular user. So anybody can access these type of clouds. For example, Gmail Drive. So in Drive, we can, if you have a Gmail account, so you can access this cloud. So Google Drive is an example of public cloud. It means any person can log in his or her Gmail account and can use public cloud. So this is called a public cloud. So second term is called private cloud. In the case of your private public cloud, there are different examples are there for public clouds. There are Microsoft Azure, there is Google Drive, Amazon Cloud Drive. So these are some examples of public cloud. For creating public cloud, the company must have resources. So there is a server is there. So you will have to maintain the server. Okay. So now next is private clouds. Private clouds are of any company, private company. These are available for employees of that company. Okay, students, time is over. Now tomorrow I will continue with this. Okay, take care. Bye. Thanks for attending the meeting with us.